And this is also a spoiler.
What is not a spoiler? Hi, I'm Lauren Schmidt-Hisrick. I am the creator of the Netflix series The Witcher.
Hi, I'm Tomek Baginski. I'm EP on the show.
And we are here to walk you through our newest trailer.
I've heard tales of your kind, Witcher. You're a mutant, created by magic.
There are a couple of moments in the trailer that are actually really important, and they seem subtle, which is a moment where Yennefer opens one of her eyes, and then another scene in which Geralt opens his eyes. For us, it's a really huge theme in our series, which is the idea of waking up into a new life, of rebirth. Yennefer's rebirth is much more visceral, let's say.
And in every episode, she has a moment of change.
It's certainly the most drastic from beginning to end. Geralt's a much slower transition of rebirth. He is grappling with what it means to be a Witcher. Every time in the trailer where you see Geralt fighting,
that's important.
It's Henry Cavill fighting. Henry does all of his own stunts on our show.
It's like true on every level. Even if we see a detail of his chest, it's Henry. Mm-hmm. Even if we see like a part of his hand, it's Henry. And I think this was the most beautiful about Henry being this character to that extent, because he became Geralt.
Roaming the continent.
We don't want your kind here.
Hunting monsters. For a price.
It's funny, because monsters are huge in The Witcher, but it's actually one of the things that we're trying to hold out of the teasers and trailers as much as possible, because we think there's a great element of surprise for existing fans who don't know what stories we're playing with and what monsters we're playing with. And also there's a couple of new monsters that we've come up with based on a lot of sort of Polish folklore.
I'm really hoping that people will be very surprised with some of our choices.
We try to have our actors interact with something real as often as possible.
We always try to limit amount of like pure CGI and just computer graphics to like the proper level, because it can be great if it's used well. Mm-hmm. But we didn't want it to overuse it. There is no better blood than real blood. Or at least fake.
Oh, so that makes it sound like we kill people at The Witcher.
No, like fake. Fake blood, but the real one.
There's a very important character in the world of The Witcher, and he makes an appearance in the trailer walking with Geralt. And this is Jaskier. There's been some drama about the fact that I chose to write Jaskier as Jaskier and not Dandelion, as he is known in English.
Some people even say that he was the guy who wrote all these stories.
Right? Yes, there's the idea that he is actually the one that's narrating all of these stories for use in his music. Jaskier thinks Geralt is his best friend in the world. Geralt doesn't necessarily feel the same about Jaskier.
He doesn't necessarily say this about Jaskier, but I think
he feels it inside?
Yeah, a little bit.
I thought you'd have fangs or horns or something.
I had them filed down.
All the brutality, all the sexuality, it's all very, very important in this world, but it's also embedded in the characters, in the story. It's not just there.
No, it's definitely sort of pushing stories forward. Yeah. Don't feel the need to shock the audience. These stories are engaging enough without really pushing a shock value of the audience.
Which doesn't mean that it's not shocking at moments.
No, it is.
People call you a monster too. Why not kill them?
Because then I am what they say I am.
We see Geralt's sword, and there's a strange object on it. And it's actually something that we delved into in the first episode. That object is the brooch of a character named Renfri. Renfri's brooch actually is something that Geralt carries with him for the rest of the series, and he sort of uses it as his guiding principle of whether or not to take action.
All of our choices draw our destinies closer.
If he is out there, there is still hope.
Judge me.
Anyone who's familiar with the books knows that Roach and Geralt have a very special relationship. Henry actually cast Roach himself because he really wanted to make sure that he, as an actor, felt the bond with the creature that Geralt is supposed to feel with Roach. Geralt obviously has two swords in the series.
Yeah, of course, he has two swords, one for the monsters, one for the humans.
And we see him mostly with his steel sword on his back. Coming into the series, I always assumed that he would actually use the silver sword more than he does.
Geralt is a monster hunter, but this danger is coming very, very often from the human side. And we never forgot about the second sword. Second sword is there with the horse. This is how it was originally done in the Andrew Sapkowski stories.
They say witches can't feel human emotion. What do you believe in?
And I was just thinking of another moment in the trailer where we see Geralt and Yennefer together. And Geralt is in a bathtub, which I think fans have been wanting and waiting for. These are two people who have been determined not to need people and not to want people in their lives, and then they intersect.
It's just the beginning of their relationship, which will be very, very stormy, but yes. Very beautiful.
Evil is evil. Lesser. Greater. Middling. It's all the same.
We play a lot with sort of the themes of good and evil in our series, and we try to make sure that in every episode we flip-flop with our characters a little bit. We look at a character who seems like the good guy, and we actually start to question his or her motivations, and we do the same thing with villains all the time as well.
It's all mixed and convoluted, and it's very, very messy, like our world.
Princess Cirilla
is your destiny. I can't protect her. If you dismiss it,
Geralt!
You will unleash true calamity upon us all.
So there is a mysterious moment with Ciri in the trailer where she has something dripping from her hands. And what we can say about it is that Ciri goes through a lot of trauma this first season, and that trauma is sort of revisited to her in her dreams and nightmares.
This is the moment where she understands that she's actually somebody else.
Yeah.
I don't think there is another show right now which is using magic so often and to that extent as we are.
We see a moment in the trailer of Geralt using Ard, which is a different type of magic.
Very, very basic battle magic. Magic is a big part of the world of Witcher, and it's also quite original because it's not just magic, it's kind of a science of this world. Geralt, to enhance his abilities as a warrior, he's using quite a lot of elixirs. They are basically poisons, but for Witchers, they are actually like enhancers. The elixirs make him faster, stronger, help him seeing in the dark.
And he actually undergoes a physical transformation as well.
Most people will consider him a monster.
I'll take that chance.
So that is all we have for you. We hope that you enjoy the trailer and stay tuned for the show to come.
And I can only say the same.